Hi everyone, welcome to Phil's Woodworking. Got a bit of a lump in my machine today, and this is hopefully going to turn into a bigger piece of this. Okay, you can see, putting it up beside, it's a little bit bigger, mainly because they want this piece, higher, so they can get some more bands around to do some more engraving. Wish me luck, and I'll be getting on with it. I'm holding this in my screw truck. Easiest way to do it to start with. I'm going to make a tenon on here, which is going to be where the cup is going to register onto anyway. So that will be my tenon as well. Then turn it round. But first of all, got to get it round. Going to use my parting off tool, and I think this is going to be possibly the easiest way, I hope. Okay, it's on the slowest speed, so it's not wobbling so much. What the wood is, it's just a piece of kiln dried, I presume it's pine from B&Q. Originally, when I first took this project on, I gave the people who wanted it done three choices. They could have it done this way with it all painted, sprayed, painted black, a bit like what they've got there, or my preferred option would have been the second option, which was to have it a piece of ash or oak laminated together, made really nice, polished up, waxed, sheened, a natural looking base, or a bit more expensive with a bit of walnut. But they chose this option, that's their choice, so that's what they're going to get, and I hope they appreciate it. I'm sure they will. And I'm sure it will still look just as good once I can get it around. And that's where we leave it for today. just using my bowl sander with 80 grit just to get this a bit smoother and get some of the tear out a bit smoother. Sorry for the noise, but I'm going to have to put my extractor on for this. What I've discovered is, even though this is kiln dry, there's a lot of sap in some of these little notches. You see these little dark places in here. I think what I'm going to do is, so that doesn't come out later on, because there's a bit of a groove in that one, a little bit in there, I'm just going to fill them with some medium CA glue just to seal it all up. And hopefully that will take care of those little bits. And then I'll start sanding again. Right. I'll be using some activator just to help it speed it up. Just to protect the bed, just put some paper towel underneath. I'm gonna fill this big one up first. Give it a quick spritz. what I could have done is actually, if it was going to be left like this, I could have put some sawdust in with the super glue just to make it look like proper wood again, but it's going to get painted, so it doesn't really matter, to be quite honest. There's the base. I've just got to sand the top just to get that a bit flatter. I've kept it on the screw chuck. This needs sanding off as well, just to make that a bit flatter. Hopefully, see, looks quite good, nice and tall, which is what they want, so they can put extra plaques on there. And then I'm just going to try the cup back on it so you can see it with the cup. That's with the cup on, fits over the boss nicely. And then what I'm going to do now is spray it black and then put a spray lacquer over the top just to seal it up. Well, I hope it looks good at the moment, and I hope it looks better when it's sprayed.